book of Daniel, chapter 12, verse 4. But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book, even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased. First and foremost, I want to give all praise to Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah Ba'ashem, Rekah Kadash. Double honor to the apostles and the elders that have spent in 2,000 before on this earth. I'm here now with Can't Be Lesson. Let's get it. And Salakia, pardon me for hearing a ruffling. I'm in my car driving to work, and the Spirit just on me to do a lesson right now. And I read that chapter with that scripture, book of Daniel, because Daniel was a prophet, and he was getting visions and seeing things to come. And that same chapter 12 and 1, and at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince was standing for the children of thy people, and there shall be a time of trouble such as never was since there was a nation, even to that same time. And at that time, people shall be delivered, everyone that shall be found written in the book of life. And I'm going to keep going down. And many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. And they that are wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn many to righteousness as the stars forever and ever. So Daniel 12 and 4. But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book, even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased. So a lot of times our ancient forefathers, you know, prophets, they got visions of things that they really couldn't grasp the concept at the time. But now we live in a time where we have access to this understanding, as far as in like what this word means. Like going to the Merriam-Webster and getting the word broken down, going to the Strong G, the Blue Letter Bible, and able to use these different apps and understanding to have a better understanding of these words. So knowledge has been increased. Even just an average kid, like compared to life 20 years ago, they have iPads and computers in front of them, and it's like they're able to process this information a whole lot faster. So we are living in a fast pace. Knowledge has been increased. But also knowing that, the time is short. Matthew 24:22. And except those days should be shortened, there should no flesh be saved. But for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened. So we're living in a time that the days are going by fast. Like, literally just came off the weekend. It's already Monday. And everybody feeling like the time shift. It's like a paradigm of events that's going on, you know, as far as just seeing the attempt assassination on the former president, probably soon to be. It like just, this is showing that times are moving, because I was just chilling this weekend. I guess it was Saturday when it happened. And my friend actually called me. I was away from my phone. I be having my phone on Do Not Disturb, just chilling. And he called me, was like, hey, you know, they try to assassinate Trump. And I'm like, huh? Like, and sure enough, I got on my phone. It was all on the internet. But I was like, you know, it's crazy. Like, I wouldn't even know what had happened if that man did get assassinated, because we probably would have went in civil war. Like, these people would have rioted, and I would have just came outside and just seeing people going crazy. And it's like, that's how quick things can turn out here in America, the times we in. So yes, knowledge has been increased. This word has been going out, being spread out throughout the internet. You know what I'm saying? Everybody's talking about biblical times. Are we in the latter times? So knowledge has been increased. This understanding of the truth has been informed. Like, people know about this. Matthew 24:14. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. So we're living at the time of the end. But the end of this kingdom, and the one ushering in the new kingdom, which will be ran by Jacob, because this is in the Esau world and beginning of his followers, Jacob. But Lord Yahweh Shah, the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, coming back. So we're living in some very interesting times, man. Very, very interesting times. Isaiah 1:4-5. A sinful nation, a people laden with iniquity, a seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors. They have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked the Holy One of Israel unto anger. They are gone away backward. Why should you be stricken anymore? You will revolt more and more. The whole head is sick and the whole heart is faint. And those are the state of our people. Consider the 2/3 and the others that's not in part of the truth in this gospel. Because all throughout generation, the Lord always said that our people got worse. And all throughout the beginning, he always said, like, we was a stiff neck, we was hard-hearted, we was stubborn, we kept sinning more and more. compared to our forefathers. So we're living in a very time of judgment and a time of things that's gonna happen. It's like, you know, when things hit the fan, it's like then everybody gonna realize that this is the truth, but it's gonna be too late for a lot of people. And I'm gonna go down Romans 11:7. What then? Israel had not attained that which it seek for, because these people are thinking that whoever the president is, it's gonna save them. But yet y'all vote every 4 years and it's the same old runaround. But yet things are getting worse for our people. But the election had attained it. The election, the chosen ones, the ones that's awoken and aware of these prophecy and the times we're living in, and the rest were blinded. So the rest were blinded. And I'm getting into that understanding, because I read that scripture too, because now a lot of people, like, they be curious, like, what religion is that? And I'm like, it's not a religion, it's a relationship. And that's the way this society trying to tend to pit on your faith and your belief. It's like it gotta be you part of a religion. No, I'm not part of no religion. This is my heritage, this is my truth, and this is the Holy Bible that which is this mass produced since the beginning of time. But yet I have good understanding because I actually study to show myself approved. So these people that gonna try your faith and like question you, it's like it's okay to be questioned, but I don't have a religion. I have a relationship with the Heavenly Father and the only begotten Son. Lord willing, I want them numbers. Daniel 12:4. But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book, even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased. So I be thinking about like how advanced society is for our current life, and I understand it, but this is the advanced level before the advancement. Like, we're in an advanced stage of life before the advancement come, when the Lord Yahweh Shah come back with the new understanding, a higher understanding, the new bodies. Because we can only go so far in these bodies as we know it anyway, because we only know so much. But even back then, the prophets and the apostles and the disciples that have a lot of these understandings that the Lord put the Spirit into write these books, they didn't even understand half the things they wrote, but they had faith and belief. And that's what we got to have in these times to come, that having faith, you know, the grain of a mustard seed that you can move mountains. It's like understanding that, like, yeah, we're not going to be able to see everything, but just having faith that the Lord is dealing with you, because we have a good chance that the Lord is actually dealing with us. And we taking heed to the scriptures, we trying to purify ourselves, you know, be praying, we paying attention to prophecy. So we have a good chance that the Lord is dealing with us. Like, what then Israel had attained that which it seek for? Israel is a nation of a people, you know what I'm saying, before it's a place, and the election have attained it. Those that are awoken are hip to the truth, the 10 virgins, if I was wise, if I was foolish, they have attained the victory already, but the rest were blinded. Hebrews 6:10 For Yahweh is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which ye have showed towards his name, and that ye have ministered to saints and do minister. And we desire that every one of you do show the same diligence to the full assurance of hope until the end, that ye be not slothful, but followers of them who through faith and patience inherit the promise. And that's why I was just saying, like, having faith and understanding that the kingdom is coming, and everything in this word, this book, is faithful and true. But having faith and understanding that the Lord is dealing with you, we gotta have faith, because things, we're not gonna be able to see things and understand some things, but we having faith and understanding that the Lord is with us. For when the Most High made promise to Abraham, because he could swear by no greater, he swear by himself. So this is the Heavenly Father putting in on his own name. You know how Jake be like, I put that on me, like, put that on me, like, I put that on my name, like, I'm him. Like, this is the Heavenly Father swearing on his name the everlasting promise to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And even, you know, they had a promise. They had a piece of the promise. They had a blessing, because Esau and Jacob was in the wombs together. And Esau got his promise. He got the fatness of the earth, and he was going to live by the sword. But Esau is the end of this world. Jacob's beginning to follow it. So the Most High, the Heavenly Father, is still holding up to this promise. So therefore, Jacob's dominionship is coming after this. And that's what you got to foresee and understand and have hope and realize, like, this is not the end all. This is the end of this understanding, but the new understanding, new world, new heaven is coming. Saying, surely, blessing, I will bless thee and multiply, and I will multiply thee. And so, after he had patiently endured, he obtained the promise. For man verily swear by the greater, and the oath for confirmation is to them an end of all strife, wherein Yahweh willing more abundantly to show unto the heirs of promise the immutability of his counsel, confirming by oath that by two immutable things in which he had impossible for the Most High to lie, we might have a strong consolation, and who have fled for refuge to lay upon the hope set before us, which hope we have as an anchor of the soul, but sure and steadfast, and which enter into the within the veil. So having the truth and his understanding, and having faith in that he words of faith and true, and we live in these times of very interesting times, you know. And it behooves you, brothers and sisters, man, take heed to this understanding, man. It's gonna get to a time that we're not gonna be able to get this word and this understanding free will. We're not gonna be able to just pop on the internet and watch these videos comfortably, because I'm gonna get this scripture. The book of Amos, chapter 8, verse 11 and down. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, nor a thirst for water, but of hearing the words of the Most High. And they shall wander from sea to sea, and from the north even to the east. They shall run to and fro to seek the word of the Lord, and shall not find it. In that day shall the fair virgins and young men faint for thirst. They that swear by the sin of Samaria, and say, they God, O Dan, liveth in the manner of Beersheba liveth, even they shall fall and never be rise up again. So it's going to get to a time that our folks are not going to have this understanding, not going to be able to assess it. Because it makes sense for them to do an internet blackout, an EMPD, electrical, on an electrical grid. Like, basically, they shut off the internet because everything's connected to the grid. So, and the Lord thirst for water, and they're hearing the words of the Lord. Because man shall not live off of bread alone, but by the words. And I'm going to get that scripture. But it's going to get to a time that we're not going to have access to the words. And we're going to have to be just out here off sheer faith and hope that the Lord is dealing with us. We all got major tribulation and great trial and tribulation coming. Matthew chapter 4, verse 3 and down. And when the tempter came to him, he said, if thou be the Son of the Most High, command that these stones be made bread. But he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out the mouth of the Most High. And this is these words. This is these words and this understanding. So your understanding, even that we're going to probably have periods of times that we're not going to have access to food, but having faith, that's why we're supposed to be fasting and be able to understand it. Like, we might be in the circumstances that we're going to have to fast and go like a period of times without eating, because America has taught us to overeat. You know, got a lot of people out here overweight, you know, gluttony. And it's good to fast. You know, I take a lot, I do it to the best of my ability, but I follow the Sabbath. And it's not always Friday, Sunday, and Saturday, Sunday, but majority of the times it is. But it's normally when a full moon. So sometimes, you know, you want to keep up with that, because we practicing. You know, we're not going to be able to follow all the laws and commandments to the best of our ability on this side, but we supposed to do it to the best of our ability, what we can do. So, you know, tell you, we're supposed to work on the side, but some of us in circumstances that we got to work. But understanding that man don't live off of bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of the Most High. This is the words. And having faith, you know, understand that the words of faith are true. So hopefully the lesson will edify. You know, I'm on my way to work. I feel like it's hard for me to really edify driving around all these crazy people, but I want to give all praise to Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah Ba'ashem, Kakadash, double honor to the apostles and the elders, and spread the truth out of the folk.